Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be all about what's on my Sephora loves list. And the reason I wanted to film this for you is because tomorrow is the start of the VIB 50% off sale. Can we just get like a little hallelujah? You know what I'm saying? I've been waiting so long for this sale and I've like been building a lot of stuff up in my loves list. You know, just to remind myself whenever I go to the store or for the sale, if I want to buy something. These are all things that I really want to try at some point. Definitely will not be buying all this at once or probably in the same year. Also, this list has been accumulating for probably over a year, so there is quite a bit of stuff on there, so just letting you know. Also, before I start this video, I just want to do a little talk about where I am. I am actually currently in Arizona for my spring break, so that's why the background is completely different. I also want to let you know that my dad is currently on the phone in our room. I closed the door and I told him I was filming. You might still hear him, but you never know. Anyway, without further ado, let's just hop on into this video. I store my loves list on Sephora app, and if you guys don't have this app, you need it, okay? It's probably actually not so great that I have it because I'm scrolling on it like throughout the day. If I get bored, I'm like, oh, look at that on my loves list. You know what I'm saying? I'm sorry if the camera switched angles miraculously. My battery is about to die, so I had to plug it into the wall. I'm not really sure which things I'm going to be buying in the sale or not, so I want you guys to let me know in the comments which things you want me to pick up and maybe do a review on or do like a tutorial with or something like that, or you think that I should just have in my collection because that's kind of helpful as well. The first thing on my list is the Too Faced Melted Liquify Longwear Lipstick in the shade Melted Sugar, which is just a really light nude. I have three others of this formula and I'm obsessed, so I really want to get this nude. I'm not really sure if this will be too light for me. I think it'll be really pretty with like a pink lip gloss on top to make like the perfect light peachy pink nude, if you know what I'm saying. The next thing on my list is new to Sephora and it is the Too Faced Little Black Book of Bronzers, and I'm super excited about this so I can try all of Too Faced bronzers for really way more inexpensive price than buying them all separately. Next, I have a Sephora Collection cream lip stain, and I have the shade Pink Souffle on my list. I've always heard Amelia Liana talk about these. I also have a perfume on my list, and this is the Bobbi Brown Beach Rollerball. This scent is basically just a kind of almost sunscreeny type scent, but I still love it, so yeah. Next, I have the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water, but this is a smaller size, but I've heard amazing things about this primer water, but I don't know if I want to spend the full $30, so getting it like a smaller size for $15 just to see if I like it, I think that would be really helpful. Next, I have the Urban Decay Naked Skin Weightless Complete Coverage Concealer. Oh my goodness, people on YouTube have been raving about this stuff so much recently, within like the last month, and I'm not really sure which shade I would be, so I'm probably not going to purchase this in the sale. Next, I have another Sephora Collection lip product, and this is their Luster Matte Longwear Lip Color in the shade Fig. I heard Melissa Parada talking about this color, and I keep seeing it swatched, and it looks absolutely beautiful. I've also heard they're really nice liquid lipsticks, and since, again, I'm really into liquid lipsticks right now, I thought that I would really love to give these a try. Now I have a couple skincare products on here. The first one is the Ola Hendrickson Glow On The Go Cleansing Cloth Trio, and I love their brightening cleansing cloth, so I thought it would be really great to try out the other two. It comes with the Clean Truth ones, which are the ones that I love, the Nurture Me ones, and the Grease Relief. So I thought that'd be really great value for the money you pay. I also have a Sephora Favorites little skincare set, and this comes with the Ola Hendrickson Grease Relief Cleansing Cloth. I'm not sure, I think this is a smaller size. It also comes with the First Aid Beauty Skin Rescue Deep Cleanser with Red Clay, which I've never tried. It also comes with the Ren Glycol Lactic Radiance Renewal Mask, which I think I've heard a little bit about the Ren skincare line. Someone in my family, I think, is having a shower, so sorry about the noise in the back. And then the last thing that it comes with is the Power Mud Dual Cleanse Treatment by Glam Glow, which, again, I've heard really great things. Then I also have a Origins Extra Zing Energizing Kit. I'm not 100% sure this is one thing that I'm leaning towards picking up in the sale, but it comes with the Ginseng Energizing and Boosting Moisturizer, which I've tried and I'm in love with. It also comes with the Ginseng Refreshing Scrub Cleanser, which I've never tried, and the Ginseng Refreshing Eye Cream, which I also haven't tried. I'm almost out of my eye cream, so getting a new eye cream would be really great. Next, I have a couple Tony Moly products on this. I've never tried Tony Moly. I think it's a Japanese brand, but the first one is the Panda's Dream So Cool Eye Stick, and I keep seeing these on Sephora, but I've never tried them out myself. but it has the cutest packaging and it's just supposed to cool your under eye area. And again, since I'm pretty much out of my eye cream, I really want to get a new eye treatment, so that's an option. I also have the Tony Moly Mini Peach Lip Balm. First of all, the packaging on this is actually shaped like a peach, which I think is really, really cute, but I've heard it smells really, really nice, so I don't think I'll purchase that one just because I have a lot of lip balms on the go right now, but sometime in the future. I also have his Peach Hand Cream, which also comes in a peach-shaped container, which again is adorable, but I heard Serene Wu, I think it was, talk about it, and she said it smells really, really nice. Next, I have some highlighters, which you guys know I'm a huge fan of highlighters. So I have two of the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Mini Liquid Illuminators. First one I have on my wish list is Opal, which I already have the pressed version of that, and I'm in love with it. So the liquid version I think would be really nice. And the other one I have on here is Moonstone, which I also the pressed, and I really like that as well. So again, I thought the liquid version would be a really great addition to my collection. And I think layering the liquid and the powder would just give you an amazing highlight. I also have the Kat Von D Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in the shade Lolita, and it just came back in stock. Oh my goodness, that is insane. It's a really beautiful nudie kind of brown shade, which everybody here on YouTube has been talking about, so I feel like that'd be a really nice color. And I love liquid lipsticks, but it's probably not going to be around for the sale. Let's be honest, it'll probably be out of stock in the next 5 minutes. The next product I have on here is a palette, and it's the Park Ave Princess Contour Palette by Tarte. And it has a bronzer, which is a Park Avenue Princess bronzer, a highlight, and a blush. And I believe the blush and highlight are limited edition. I just love the colors, and I swatched them in Sephora, and I was like, but yeah. Okay, the next thing is by Benefit, and it's the Puff Off Eye Brightener and Depuffing product. And this has been talked about a lot again on YouTube, and I felt the consistency. It looks really brightening on my hand, but it also feels really cooling, which I think would be great, especially since I have really dark under eye circles. I think it might kind of help with that as well. The next product is by Sephora. This is the Color Adapt Lip Gloss, and I love color adapting products, and this looks really pretty. Again, I've swatched it quite a few times, and I love the way it looks. I just haven't gotten around to picking it up yet. I also have one of their Rouge Infusion lip stains, and this is in the shade Rosewood Elixir, and these look really nice. Again, I've swatched pretty much all of these lip products, and I absolutely love the way they look, but this one I really love the packaging, and I love how lightweight it felt on my hand. I also have another one of their Luster Matte Lip Creams. This one is in the shade Petal, which is like a nudie pink color. Again, I really want to try this, but the color looks absolutely gorgeous. The next thing I have on here is by Bite Beauty, and this is their Luminous Cream Lipstick Duo in the shade Fig and Date. I have one of their other nude duos, which I love. I love it. I think it's a great value for your money, so this would be a really nice little duo to pick up. I have another Tony Moly product on here, and this is the Panda's Dream Brightening Eye Base. This one isn't the cooling one, this is a brightening one, so I'm not really sure which one would be best. If you guys have tried these, let me know in the comments. I have another Benefit product on here. This is the Porefessional License to Blot, and I love the Porefessional powder and primer, so this I think would be really great. I also have the Sephora Collection Color Reveal Lip Balm, and this is supposed to be just like the Dior lip glow, which I love as well. So this I think would be a really great dupe for it if it works out. This product I've heard a lot of people talk about here on YouTube, and is the Benefit Majorette Cream Blush, and I'm a huge fan of cream blushes. This is a beautiful coral color, and it's kind of a cream to powder formula apparently. I think it'd be perfect for the spring and summertime, so I really want to try that out. I also have an Urban Decay Moon Dust eyeshadow on here. This is in the shade Solstice. It's a beautiful kind of almost like a purpley brown with a really pretty duochrome in it. It's a really beautiful shimmer of like a teal, and I've seen a lot of tutorials with this on YouTube. I feel like it's a really unique product. You won't be able to find anyone else making a color like this, so I really want to try that one out as well. Going back to Benefit, I have one of their boxed powders. This is in the shade Dallas. Again, a lot of people have been loving this recently. It's a beautiful dusty rose color. I really like it. I think it would be a beautiful neutral to go with any makeup look. Now, this product I will for sure be purchasing. It's the Too Faced Hangover Replenishing Face Primer. I, again, have felt this so many times in Sephora, like swatched on my hand, and it feels so cooling and awakening, but it's $40 Canadian, which I think is kind of ridiculous for a primer. So getting the 15% off will lower that to like $32, which I think is a lot more, I guess, justifiable, maybe, if that's the right word. Now I have a blush from Tarte on here, and this is one of their Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Blushes, which I love. This is in the shade Captivating. It's a beautiful coral color. I used to hear a lot of people talking about this. I just never got around to picking it up. Next, I have the Urban Decay Naked Flush Palettes, the other three, which I do not own. I already have the shade Naked Creative, which I love, but I have the color Streak, Naked, and Strip on here. They're beautiful colors. They all have a little bit of a different tone to them, which I really like. I will, again, not be purchasing these all together in the future. Probably in the next couple of years, I'll be purchasing them one by one, but I love the formula of these. I love how compact they are, and they're just such great products, so I love them. Next I have the Bite Beauty Lush Fruit Lip Gloss in the shade Rambutan, and I love this color. It's such a beautiful nude, and I feel like I just need it. I have the shade Cocoa and a little smaller one of the shade Current, and I love them, and I really wanted to get Rambutan. I feel like it's one of those ones that everybody has in their collection, and it's just like a staple. I also have a bunch of other Bite Beauty products on here. The first one being the Luminous Cream Lipstick in the shade Retsina, which is a really pretty nude. Again, a lot of people love this on YouTube, and I keep loving it in the store, but never purchasing it. I also have three of their high pigment lip pencils on here. The first one is Syrah, which is like a nice peachy nude. I also have Bouquet, which is a beautiful pink. It's just like a nice, I guess, medium tone pink. And then Madeira, which is more of a mauvey nude. I love this formula of the high pigment lip pencils, but I've never gotten around to purchasing another one yet. Next, I have the Benefit Ultra Plush Lip Gloss in the shade Rocketeer, and I love their lip gloss formula. It's very lightweight. Then I also have the Tarte Lip Surgeon's Matte Lip Tint in the shade Exposed. I really like matte lip colors, and this just looks so beautiful. I've seen Rach Loves talk about this a lot, and I think it's just so pretty. Then I also have the Coors Lip Butter in the shade Jasmine, which looks like a really pretty baby pink lip balm. I've heard, again, a lot of people loving these. They've kind of died down, I guess, over the years, but a couple years ago, they were really high in demand, so I really want to try one of those eventually. And the last product on here is the Bite Beauty Agave Lip Mask. And people love this here on YouTube. I've always put it on my lips in the store just to see if it really works, and it really sinks in. But again, I have quite a few lip balms on the go right now, so probably won't be purchasing it in the sale, but I really want to try it eventually. So that's everything that is on my Sephora loves list. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you give it a big thumbs up if you did. Let me know in the comments which things you think I should purchase in the sale, and also which items you are planning on purchasing, because I can always get ideas from you. I will make sure to link my Sephora loves list down below in case you want to go and add that to your loves list. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat, with all the links are down below. That's all for today's video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!
Too Faced Melt Liquify.
What's your little apartment?
Dad, I'm filming a video.
Is mom there?
No.